Hello and welcome you again to my channel Computer Conversation. With this video I am going to create a playlist where I will upload videos related to network. I will start by introducing you to computer network. The video is divided into three parts. This is part 1. I will give the part 2 and part 3 link in the description when I will upload. These are the topics that I will cover in all the three parts. Timestamps for each topic are mentioned in the description. Please watch this video till the end to understand every topic clearly. So what does computer network means? It is nothing but a set of interconnected devices, or you can call nodes, which are connected by some communication medium or links. The devices may be computer, printer, camera, etc., which are capable of sending or receiving data to or from other nodes in the network. Below is the diagrammatic representation of a network of a mobile, laptop, desktop and a printer connected by some communication links. Hope the meaning of network is clear to you. Now, after knowing what a network is, we should also know why or how network is important to us. We can't think of the world without emails, blogs, videos, etc., right? All these things are done based on network. We can also perform several other activities like sharing resources, files, etc. Let me discuss with you some uses of network. First is file sharing. If you want to share any files like image, text, document, etc., with other users, we can do this in a network. Second is hardware sharing. We can also share hardware like printers, scanners, hard drives, etc. within a network. For example, in cafes, there are generally one or two printers, and there are 5 to 10 computers depending on cafe size. Therefore, each computer do not have separate printers for them. Instead, there are only one or two printers. So to get printing done from each computers, all computers need to connect to the printer. This forms a network where the printer, which is the hardware, is being shared by all other computers. Third is application sharing. If we want to share any application, we can also do this. Fourth is user communication. We can also communicate with other users in the network using emails, video conferencing, etc. And fifth is network gaming. Many games are available that can be played by many users together over a network. Most common example of this game is Counter-Strike. Hope the importance of network is also clear to you. Now, a network can be of different types. We should know about them. There are generally three types of network based on coverage area. There are also many more types of network you will find on the internet, which are the sub-classifications of these three types of network only. So the three types are local area network or shortly LAN, metropolitan area network or MAN, and wide area network or WAN. Now let's discuss these networks one by one in more detail. Okay, first comes the local area network. The networks which are confined or limited within very small area, such as any network within schools, offices, etc., are referred to as local area network. Since the network is within very small area, so it has private addressing schemes. It means that the addresses of the devices within the network is unknown outside the network. Since the network size is small, therefore the data transfer speed is very high. The network size is limited only to few kilometers and is easy to design and maintain. For this network, we generally use twisted pair or coaxial cable and can achieve data transfer speeds from 10 Mbps to 100 Mbps. Also, the propagation of signals is very fast and so has very short propagation delay. This network has high fault tolerance. It means that it can tolerate maximum of the faults if occur. Also, due to lower number of devices connected in the network, the congestion that occurs due to transmission of signals in the network is also low. In the right side, I have shown you a diagrammatic representation of LAN inside an office where 6 users or computers are connected with each other. Next, let's know about metropolitan area network. This type of network is confined within comparatively larger geographical area than LAN. The network size can be within same or different cities. This network also has high data transfer speed and can go up to 150 Mbps. But compared to LAN, MAN is harder to design and maintain as the size of this network is much more than LAN. This network uses modem or cable to transfer data. Now since this network is much larger in size, therefore we notice signal propagation delay at moderate level. Also due to large number of devices connected to the network, the congestion of signals that are being transmitted is more and can tolerate less fault. If excessive fault occurs, this network system may crash. In the right side, you can see a diagrammatic representation of man. Here are two cities, city 1 and city 2. Within each of these two cities, there are two regions, region 1 to region 4. Each of these regions has one user. The network formed by the dotted and the thick lines can be considered as man. It is because the network is formed with users within the same city as well as two different cities. Hope the explanation was clear to you. Next, let's switch to the third type of network, that is wide area network. This type of network covers the largest geographical area. The size of the network has no limitation. The data transfer speed of this network is also high. Since this is the largest sized network, it is definitely hard to design and maintain, and also we need to transfer data with high speed. For that, we use optical fiber cables or microwave or satellite signals, which can transfer data at very high speed than any coaxial or twisted pair cable. Now, as very large number of devices are connected to the network, therefore it is obvious that many errors may occur by some reason in transmitting signals, and also has much more signal congestion in the network than LAN or MAN. And if excessive fault occurs, the network system may crash due to less fault tolerance. And also noises occur due to external unwanted signals that may come with microwave or satellite signals. The diagram beside represents a WAN. Here are three countries. Country 1 and Country 2 has two separate networks. Within Country 3, in State 1, there is a separate network and a user 4 in Region 1. The network formed by all the connections shown by orange dotted lines can be considered as wide area network. Now this is all about the three different types of network. Hope every point was clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment below or mail me in the mail address given below in the description. After learning about the types of network, let's learn some characteristics of a network. First one is performance. A network must have the highest performance it can have to complete any work very efficiently. The performance of a network is measured in terms of signal transmit and response time, or how efficient any hardware or software is that are involved in a network for data transmission. Second is reliability. A network must also be very much reliable. It is measured by accuracy of data delivery, how frequently data delivery failed, time taken by a link to recover from a failure, and the network's robustness. Third is security. A network must also be very secure, such that no data transmitted in a network leak outside the network. A network must have features to protect data from unauthorized access, recover and develop and implement policies and procedures to recover from data losses. Fourth is sharing resources. A network has the ability to share files or any other information or application to other computers in the network. And the fifth one is scalability. A network can be scaled by adding more computers to it, which improves the performance of the network. Hope the characteristics part is also clear to you. Take time to understand everything. Next, I am going to discuss about network architecture. It means how each of the computers in the network are organized and how different tasks are allocated to them. In a network of different computers, the users may choose a particular computer to store all information, and the other computers will access any required information from that computer. Or the users can store different types of information in different computers, and any computer can access the information from the corresponding computer where the information is kept. Depending on this, the architecture can be of two types: peer-to-peer architecture and client-server architecture. Now let's learn about these architectures one by one. First one is peer-to-peer architecture. In this type of architecture, each of the computers linked together have equal privilege or rights and responsibilities for data processing. Every computer must be powerful enough to complete the responsibilities. This kind of architecture is useful when the network size is very small and has no server concept, as it is not needed at all. The architecture has some advantages as well as disadvantages, which are pointed out below. Let's first see the advantages. The architecture is easy to set up and maintain, less costly as no server is present, and if any of the computers fail, other computers will still work in the network. Now the disadvantages. As this architecture is not a centralized system, it is difficult to backup any data. It is because if you want to backup any data, you cannot do it to a central computer where all files will be present. Instead, you have to choose a computer each time where you want to backup, which becomes difficult. Also, the architecture has security issue because every computer can access every data from every computer, as every computer has equal rights and responsibilities. This architecture is clearly shown in the diagram on the right, where every computer is connected to each other and has same privileges and responsibilities. Now moving on to the second type of architecture, which is client-server architecture. Unlike peer-to-peer architecture, this architecture has a central computer known as server, and other computers known as clients or end users access different resources like songs or video, etc. from the server. The server contains every information that the clients connected to it may need. The server is very much powerful than the clients, and it must perform special operations like security, network management, managing resources such as files, directories, etc. This architecture also has some advantages and disadvantages. Let's first talk about the advantages. Backing up of data is easy unlike peer-to-peer architecture because it has the centralized computer called server where all data is kept. And this provides better security as all data is kept in the server and the server performs that security operation which helps to secure the data. Now the disadvantages. Since the server must be very much powerful as it performs all the operations of the connected computers that are distributed in all computers in the peer-to-peer architecture, it increases the cost of forming the architecture, also requires huge amount of memory and the cost of network operating system or NOS that is used to run the server is also high, which ultimately increases the cost very much. Hope all the things that I discussed till now is clear to you. If you have any doubt, definitely ask in the comment section below. Now let's move to the quiz part. Here are some questions. You need to answer them to the point and you can mail the answers to the mail address given below on the screen to keep your answers private. I'll reveal the answers in a video after I upload all the 3 parts of the video. And I'll also announce the names who will answer correctly if I get enough responses. Join me on Instagram and Telegram to get regular updates. Links of both these social medias are given in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Thank you. Meet you in the next video.